G'day guys, welcome to Atlantic War, one of Sahinko's maps for the second match in the Awarded War 1v1 test tournament. And this is Handzy's last chance to stay in the tournament, losing the first one. We have Shota going Soviets and Handzy as Finland. He's gone a regular. This map should play well to the regular squad, and I think this is Handzy's host, so he has the advantage in terms of micro, but this is a good map for the Soviets, I think, to do well with a bad ping on this.
Yeah, especially with that T-60, just able to mow down infantry galore. We'll see how this regular squad goes. Looks like Handzy's going to go ahead and reposition on these bags that are kind of left of center, I guess, depending on which way you're facing, Strat. does have that nice rifleman with the semi-scope.
Yeah, that's makes actually the Finnish squad a bit better than the others right now. Even the USA regulars in the extended shootout, they do take a while to make effect, but we decided to actually take that out and integrate it to the scout unit in the next patch. So hopefully we get more scout usage. Oh, sorry, scout recon usage in the next patch. Handzy capping the center just momentarily. Shadow still has a considerable force in the area. Eastern Point has, looks like it's a pretty even fest, micro fest, but there's an MG on the top, but not a great MG. But look at that Pippisher fire. And a Molotov from Handzy doesn't hit its mark. Western obviously going Shadow and is quite well entrenched in that point. Even start so far.
Yeah, you're exactly right. Looks like there's a battle over here on the Eastern flag. Nice grenade by Shatter. Although there looks like the SMG going to go ahead and reinforce this point as well. Looks like we have an assault squad coming from Shatter as well. Whoa, what is this, a double buy?
Partisans as well. So I guess as a Soviets versus Finland, you do have that extra money because it's a bit cheaper. Assault squad from Handzy moving to the Western. May struggle with the entrenched force already in position of ambush. Unfortunately, the semi-sniper from Handzy's looks like it's glitched in the wrong area and it can't fire. It seems to be stuck in that aim shot. Eastern Point, though, is going to receive an assault of with the assault squad of Shutter, with not much holding it back and potentially a 3-cap unless Handzy can marker his way into the West.
Yeah, that partisan squad that Shutter double-bide just got it caught out in the open. The last thing you want is a partisan squad getting caught out in the open like that with these SMGs from the Finnish squad here.
Shutter doing okay though on the Western to hold momentarily. Handzy swinging to behind the logs to get some extra flanking perhaps. Center is still Shutter's. That aim shot for that semi-sniper still glitched. But Handzy manages to hold to the Eastern Point. Must have killed a lot of guys there. Western, still Shutter's and hasn't really lost anything to that full assault squad that Handzy sent there. Another assault squad from Handzy coming to the center, and also another assault squad from Shutter going to reinforce the west, and that will definitely put Handzy's assault in its tracks on the west.
It's gonna We're seeing a typical AS2 meta here right now, right?
Yep.
So much for the mod.
Yeah, both very assault squad heavy nations, the best SMG in the game, plus the second best SMG in the game. Why not, I suppose. So the regulars can do well in this map. Here comes the lightning squad from Handzy. You can see them running so fast with that looks like a brownish red kind of backpack on them. Very fast, as you can see. I don't know if it's a true story, apparently. They're made off the guys that took drugs and were sent into battle, and apparently made them run really fast and stuff like that. So drug addicts, junkies coming to the Western Point. Let's see how they go.
Looks like we have those Spetsnaz coming. Speaking of that, right where that lightning squad was going.
Ooh, look at this ambush. Pippisher on the lightning squad. Oh no. Oh now. Oh wow, look at that. So expensive. One special point lost to nothing just by one Pippisher looking the wrong way. And then as the lightning squad passed, it mowed them down. So it was lucky that it was looking the wrong way. So it didn't fire to reveal itself until the right moment. Spetsnaz coming through from Shota. Center is capped by Handzy though. Trailing 13-0.
Yeah, he is trailing 13-0, but it looks like he's going to go ahead and stabilize with the middle cap. He does have a reservist squad, I guess, probably just some line of sight on that side there, since he has no troops over there.
Interesting. Just for line of sight, I guess. T-60 is coming. There's a T-50 counter, though, straight away. I guess he saw that coming or heard it coming. Not too many targets.
That's a quick buy, huh? Yeah.
5 minutes in. Not many targets, but at least Handzy's got the direct counter for it straight away. And should be able to put it away from this range. T60 will struggle. There's the track. But here comes the SMG. I'm taking
it's
a grenade.
It's interesting that T50 got turreted as well.
Really? Is it turreted?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, it is too. God damn it.
Yeah. Yeah, it looks like he's taking out the T60, but he doesn't have a lot of inventory in front of this T50. Actually, the bill's getting decapped. Whoa, this SMG is actually going to pull up.
No, there's nothing stopping it. That rifleman, no, it's doing the aim shot. It's too late. Oh no, unfortunate. Handzy lost that battle because the T50 is a little bit more expensive. Oh no, it's not actually in this mod. T60 is pretty much the same price. The T60 though is repairable, which Shadow is doing.
What's the T60? Because the T50 is 290.
290, I think?
Oh, it's the same price.
Yeah, same price.
Yeah, Timo with the rifle scope here unfortunately did not save that T50 from getting destroyed there. Although it does doing a good job right now, 9 kills.
Yeah, Timo doing very well. Also the name of the maker, this Deja Vu Simus, by the way. it must be a Finnish name. Maybe it's like the Bob of Finland, I don't know. Pringle's brother, by the way, made a lot of the Finnish nation's units. And his name is Timo. And he's doing a very good job in this game too. Veterancy to 10. As you can see, the aim shot of the semi-sniper doing very well. He's the guard sniper from Shotter. Partisans as well, and White Death from Handzy.
Timo's gonna have to watch out for those Mosin snipers, huh? We don't want them going down. We're rooting for you, Timo. Yeah, we'll see if White Death can counter those Mosin snipers. In the first game, we saw that White Death did really good against the snipers, the dual snipers.
Indeed, Mosin snipers picking a few MGs of Handzy's. Though it doesn't have a scope, but I remember the Finnish White Death, so most of the sniper can counter it if the user of the White Death is complacent. It needs to really keep moving, fires really fast and just move as soon as you fire, and the other snipers can't counter snipe you. Tankru from Shotup.
Huh?
He's obviously expecting the T60 to be repaired any moment now. Spetsnaz are through, sneaking to the backfield. Lightning Squad again from Handzy, coming down to the center. Hopefully they do a bit better for him this time. And on the western point, Handzy has taken it. I didn't realize that. And an Assault Squad from Shotter is trying to make its way in. Really, you can just run in the center. Handzy's got the majority of troops, I think, and can grenade off that T60 if he wishes. And I think it's... The hull's been repaired and just the track now is damaged, so T60 can be manned.
Yeah, once the T60 gets back up, it's going to mow down all this infantry in the middle here. Definitely should be something that's a priority right now. Looks like we have a Lancer coming out, and that definitely would be able to take the T60, so that's a really strategic buy at a good time right now for Handzy.
Yeah, interesting unit to be bought. Seems like it is the go-to for these players, first game and now this game. Maybe it's part of the Finnish meta now, like every game, because even this map is quite open. It's not a map where the 40 mil can really fight the counter very well. It needs to really time itself to run away. But there goes the guard sniper, one of the guard sniper, the White Death has taken it out. Is the other sniper dead, Simons? I can't see another one. Maybe they're both, oh no, they're, sorry, I see it now. It's moving back to the center.
Yeah, it looks like it's on the western flag. Yeah, it's going to move back over to the middle here.
See it running in. White Death doing job. Its job, wow, SMG soldier, top scoring so far, then the T50, then the White Death, which will slowly creep up. Nimrod, now stopping the center, and Handzy is capping it. Let's see what counter this shot to come up with, a 76. Handzy noticing this right away, and he's running away. Very, very good prediction from Handzy, or very good hearing. Seems to be able to predict when the units come out, like the T60. Now this T-476.
I may get a grenade off with Handzy here.
Huh?
Let's take the AC grenade on the 76. Of course it just misses.
It took out the guard sniper though.
The one thing with AT grenades on Finland is you have to actually cook them. And that can be a little bit of an issue when you're trying to gun for a tank there.
Yep, has those timers, and Hungary as well has that issue with 80 grenades exploding on impact. But another grenade perhaps from Handzy, but there's still the opportunity. He cooked it for too long there, and it exploded in his hand. I guess,
did
wow.
he just blow himself up?
Yeah, I think he just tried to throw a grenade on that T-76, but cooked it for too long. Landsberg shot, one shot, and really, I think if it was actually another nation, he would have killed that T-34, and his big unit, Landsberg, would have survived. So that's definitely a big weakness for Finland.
Having said that, he's actually going for a 3-cap right now, Strat. He's actually capping the Western flag with, some SMG troops there, plus a sneaky assault squad leader here.
AT rifle nearly took out that half track, and half track does escape, luckily, and is now behind the house. I don't know if the AT rifle can take it out now. Nope. Bazooka misses as well. Luckiest half track in the game. And
luckiest half track. It's smoking too, and it's not moving. Oh, there goes the AT rifle on it.
T-34 back in the way.
You alright, Strat? Smoking too much? Looks like they charged units out, and it's gonna go towards, I guess, the eastern flag here.
Yep, he left the flag there behind, though. It's no inspiration for those troops now. What were they gonna do? Pro tip, guys, that flag bearer actually has a lot of hit points and speed, so you can kind of take the hits for the other units behind in the charge.
Interesting. Good to know. T-76 is pulling up for some support here. I wonder what's going to be countered for that. Looks like we do have the Spetsnaz that have fanned out and really are in the backfield, though. Handzy, that could be really dangerous if he does buy a counter for it.
Yeah, interesting play. We saw that with Tedessa using Spetsnaz in a 2v2 tournament. Handzy does have a Shrek with the border Jaegers, so he's bought the elite squad, but deciding to go back. And here's the Tawny from Handzy. Let's see if he can use this well. Looks like he split them into two so far. On the left, he's got an MG and two Panzerfausts, and the center has the majority of weight with the two snipers and the rest. I wonder if the White Death is still alive. Do you know if he's still alive?
Yep, he is. He's got 12 kills. He's actually right in the middle of the Tawny squad on this little ridge here.
I see.
So it can be confusing because Tawny is looks like he's been just grouped together.
He's been assimilated into the Tawny squad.
Yeah, apparently. He's going to teach him his ways. Did you just see that? 76 went down by Handzy. Nice Panzer Shrek.
Yeah, that same Shrek I noticed before. Yeah, snuck in. Very, very well played. He's noted for his bazooka play. Yeah, definitely he was a bad student when I was teaching him how to play. I told him bazooka's a casino and useless, but he just kept on with it.
He didn't listen to you.
Yeah, and it is definitely turning it into a very good strategy, tactic.
I think with Finland, it can definitely be a viable strategy. He actually has, if you look at it, he has bazookas on every side of the map right now. Western, Eastern, and Middle, of course. That is Handzy's play.
Indeed.
I haven't seen him build any sandbags yet, but we'll see him for sure.
Yeah, strange
actually,
enough.
Actually, I take that back. He does have sandbags right
now. T-60 is out from Shotter, and we'll have a bit of a nice shoot in the center. There's a T-50 out. Standard counter for 20 mils so far in this 1v1 tournament. Exactly the same price as the T-60, but doesn't do much else other than counter it. Now, T-60 is running away. I think it's going to escape. 37 to 15, Handzy is still ticking up as he's capping the eastern point. He's got a very strong hold, I guess, now on the flags. The Tawny squad definitely gives a lot of firepower with the 4-star accuracy of every single troop in there.
Oh, there's just a grenade thrown on one of the guy in the middle, and the guy in the middle threw it back and actually killed both the soldiers that were engaging there. That was hilarious.
What a hero.
You had to have seen it. What I'm saying.
Yeah, I saw it in the background slightly.
Looks like, Handzy's definitely going for a 3-cap right now, Strat. The Tawny squad is really pushing back Shotter. He has no immediate threat or counter for any of this. He doesn't have any stronghold on any flag right now. This could be death right now.
Yeah, unfortunately for the Spetsnaz, there's no big heavy targets. Looks like Handzy was just playing infantry, and that's Finland really to a T. Infantry plus the regular counters of the T-50s. Other than that, the Spetsnaz have nothing but just line of sight. But here's a charge from Shotter, and they'll run into a few SMGs and a sniper. It's actually White Death, so kind of interesting.
Yeah, but the T-60 is coming up, though. That should definitely help that person. Charge squad.
And White Death could meet its end. I think the vineyards are kind of blocking it from shooting. Instead, he's going to micro his way in with grenades. White Death, yeah. Oh, he's almost dead. I think one more shot to the face.
Oh, it's knocked out. Yeah,
I think it's dead. There's too many guys, and he doesn't notice. I think once he had Tawny Squad out, he just lost track of where everything was.
Yeah.
And White Death was just another sniper in his army.
That's sad. Sad that White Death went down like that. But he does still hold 49, 15, 50, 15, somewhere in that range. I think that T-50 can counter that T-60, though.
Yep. It's got its side exposed, though. The hill, there's a little slight hill blocking the two, though, so...
Oh, the Spetsnaz is coming for the T-50. Yeah.
Yep.
Well, what is it doing?
Yeah, I don't know. I would probably just be a bit more patient, because that T-60 can just wait. And here is that Spetsnaz. Please don't crash. I've got a close-up. Oh, bad luck. It's running away. Oh, it's tracked. But it can't be penetrated. Oh, grenade. Spetsnaz, do something. Oh, Spetsnaz.
Yeah, dynamite or something? Doesn't it have something?
Yeah, it's too slow. It's going crazy now. It's taking revenge, killing his T-60 mate. Run away, though. What's this? This is the third tier. Third tier of the Finnish squad. I don't know what the Carpaccio. What's your best take on it? Kakapatio. How do you say that, Simus?
I don't even know what you're talking about.
Okay, right, click on now. The squads.
Oh, yeah. Kakapatio. Yeah, that sounds good. I'll go with that one.
Kakapatio. All right, I bet you Arcturus is going to be laughing at us right now.
He's going to give us some information on how to pronounce these before we cast them.
Yeah, it's unfair. He probably learned English at school from a young age. We never learned Finnish. I can't speak English. I learned English at school, but I learned Finland.
A T-60 just got cut out in the open by that T-50, though, unfortunately. I don't know where that T-60 was going. Seems like it was way out in the open there.
Yeah.
So Handzy still holds two flags, the 164, 35. Or 15, sorry, my vision.
It's not over for Shotter.
He's
got a red guard coming in. Red guard squad, so he's got the tier to punch through. But these guys holding the point are actually of the red guard status as well, and they have the same weapons. The DP-27 Soviet gun used against the red guards. But here's a possible bazooka on the T-50. Ooh, tracks and just misses the hull. One Spetsnaz still in the backfield. Nothing else from Shotter.
Here comes another one. Oh, nice AC shell by the T-50. He actually takes out the second red guard with the bazooka.
Ooh,
there.
Clutch plays, holding on to the center. Though on the western point, there's a few guys ready to assault that from Handzy. Here's a big push from a charge unit. Shotter coming to the eastern point. It's going to meet a lot of machine guns, I think.
Yeah, you're right. Looks like they're positioning right now to get ready for this charge unit here. The sandbag being built. That is Handzy style.
The guys in the center as well can fire onto them too. In between the center and eastern point.
What is the guy with the flag going to do?
He's going to run in, show them the way, but the T-50 is going to get in there as well. And... no, it's not. It's just going to run away because he sees a counter, a T-34-76.
Yeah, interesting. We haven't seen a 57 or anything larger than that. We haven't seen any big tank buys yet.
Yeah, in my opinion, you don't need that versus Finland. Finland's just all out infantry. Center is getting capped by hand. No, capped by Shota momentarily. He's a partisan squad now.
Yep, 76-15.
Watch
well
this.
In hand up.
Panzer Shrek from Oh, Shota's been very good with killing those 8 infantries. T-50 for a 50-50. Oh, bounces. I don't know if it can penetrate at this range. It's got a fast reload, as you can see. Oh, it's tracked. Oh, turreted. That's close enough. Maybe get another, get a track as well. But here's an AT grenade from Shota. Yep. There goes that T-50. And straight to Landsberg from Handzy. Ooh. Let's see how fast he can take that T-34-76 before it gets repaired. He has taken this the western point as well. Let's see. Oh, he's approaching from the side, Simus.
Yeah, he's trying to take out that T-34-76 as well as clear out this infantry in the middle here. I think he's going for the win right now.
I don't think there's any.
If he takes out that 76, then he can definitely take out the remaining infantry in the middle and go ahead and cap it for a 3 cap and definitely close the game out here.
Yeah, what happened there? Shota just charged. I mean, maybe a bit of lag. There's no bazookas left in that Red Guard squad, so it's going to be very unlikely he's going to get 80 grenaded. Wow, a lot of the Landsberg has done a fantastic job so far.
Donner's done a good job in actually capping the Western flag, though, so he has taken that. It's not going to be his death immediately. He's going to have to go ahead and cap another flag, though, here momentarily.
True.
See if that lands for him. Take out the 74-76. Looks like we have another 76 coming up, though.
Oh, wow.
Reinforce.
That's interesting. I don't know. Both of them aren't very good at infantry support. Oh, no. There goes the one T-34. Maybe even the second one might get main gun turreted. Tansy's trying.
I think it's funny he's hiding behind the building. And the other one is not even shooting.
Cheeky, cheeky bastard, but no go. That shell went through the building or something.
Yeah, there's a window right open right there.
Ah, through the window. What?
He's got a guy right there. Molotov on him. Huh? Is he gonna burn though?
How?
There's a guy standing right there, reservist. No, he's not gonna burn though. Not from that. No way. Is he gonna burn? Is he gonna burn shit?
What? Is that possible? I never seen environments. He got burnt by the bush.
It's possible. We've seen it here right now. So what have I already seen this before? But
I swear I've seen bushes get burnt and things not happening. I don't know. That's my first time I saw that.
That is definitely game changer right.
That's
there. 96-15. This looks like all Handzy right now. Does have another. What is this? What squad is this coming up? Parchio squad.
That one.
But here comes the BA-11, though.
BA-11. It's a sign of someone low on MP. Bazooka miss. Oh, it takes out the bazooka. Oh, wow. He's actually stopped the cap. And there's no more bazookas around, I don't think. Oh, no, there's a Panzerfaust. Misses. So he's stopped the 2 cap and he's still in it. Just needs a bit more infantry, but a guy sneaking from the side perhaps. Oh, what was that? Is that 80 grenade? No, he's gotta escape that. Bear 11 walking back. I just saw a Shota as well buying 2 Spetsnaz. He had another Spetsnaz squad.
Got a Red Guard squad kind of as well.
Ooh.
Reinforce the middle here.
Elite marksman squad from Shota.
Should be a whole AT infantry.
Did decent buy.
AT rifle, sorry.
Oh, AT rifle. Oh no. Yep, definitely the right buy from Handzy. But that Elite Marksman squad is actually the supreme squad in the center at the moment. Wonder if the Spetsnaz should come out and play now.
Yeah. I mean, definitely has them in the background. They haven't really proved their worth for what the position that he's had them in. Definitely need to use them right now. Down 96-15. It's you make one more mistake and you're dead. Wow, what squad is this?
That's an
this is same squad.
Thing. Okay. No, it's not. It's Kapapa.
Oh yeah, that one. Okay, gotcha.
It's the pancake squad. The KP squad. KP squad.
Yeah, that sounds good. We'll call them. Oh, nice shot.
Too close. Oh, wow, missed. Red Guard's now a bit outnumbered, I think. Oh, wow, the Tanku actually did something.
They still can work. Are you serious, Handzy? Come on.
Right now, the Spetsnaz actually could play the deciding role in the combat because I think both players are pretty much out of money. Spetsnaz picked up an MG.
I know,
five
right?
Stars.
Or just ambush the next squad that comes in or something. I mean, even with their little pistols, they could do some work if you're not paying attention. Looks like Hansi's trying to cap the middle though, and if he caps this, that could be game.
Yep, capping with the AT rifle. Nice click grenade, misses though. Not nice then. Almost nice. Some red guards at the back from Shotter on the roadway. Not participating at the moment.
Yeah, I would definitely be using these Spetsnaz right now. Ooh. I mean, you gotta use everything you got.
Well, check out the buy from Shotter.
What? Heavy MG, nice.
Interesting.
We'll see if it gets there in time.
Yeah, if it gets there
it
in time.
It should. The flag's not even being capped right now, so it definitely should be able to get there. I actually kind of like that buy strat. Mm. Kind of expensive, though. And he doesn't have a lot of inventory.
Yeah, it's not bad, I guess. I guess so.
Definitely nothing to counter it right now. In theory.
Yeah, true. Just get the Spetsnaz up to participate a bit as well.
I can't. Actually, it's missing a lot, though.
It's so inaccurate, isn't it?
Maybe it's the angle or something.
It might even get outshot by the Elite Marksman. And it's not going to stop the guy capping in that little ditch.
Oh, that ditch right there, that hole right there is actually... That's the game changer right there, the hole.
It's the hole. Handzy, sneaky business. It's AT rifle capping as well.
He's gonna sneak this victory with an AT rifle in a hole. Is that what he's gonna do?
It's not far off. Look at that. The MG actually got outshot.
Oh, here comes the Spetsnaz coming in.
Ooh.
Spetsnaz doing work.
Oh, it might stop the cap. Definitely. Can it stop the cap? It needs to stop the cap. Oh. Handzy using the ping advantage. Easily micros away from that grenade. Spetsnaz is now just nothing. It's gone to... to Valhalla. Is that what the Finnish guys, or is that, I don't know. They're from Scandinavia, right? They've got the Viking mythology gods.
Yeah, these guys behind cover are actually just avoiding the MG. The MG is... I thought it would be better buy, but it just is not hitting anything.
I know. Pretty horrible, in fact. Look at that. Elite Marksman just picks off the crew like nothing.
Wow. It's just like, it shot his entire clip and then like, it started reloading and then like, Elite Marksman was like, nah, you're dead.
Mind you, it's a lot cheaper though in the mod. I think it's just 80 MP or something, the Soviet one.
Oh, here comes a 220 tractor. That's gonna run that over.
Handzy bought that as a single buy. That is interesting. And that is actually that's all he needed. Running over. Partisans can't do a thing. What? It's being a bit cheeky there.
Is that the play of the turn so far? I don't know.
T20 has...
T20 for the win.
Yeah. honest. I can't tell.
That's awesome. 96, 15, 30 minutes in almost.
I don't know, I've just noticed that the T20 tractor has three seats on each end. So if you wanted to, you can make a special unit with six guys sitting on it. Anyway, good game.